Hi all, electrical engineer Igor Ekimov is with you. Today we will be reviewing the A3008 pen multimeter. Initially, this multimeter did not seem serious to me. What can such a small multimeter hold? But when I started to understand it, this device surprised me. Therefore, watch this video to the end to learn more about this amazing device. If you are interested in videos about electrical, plumbing and repairs, then subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. The device itself is the size of a marker, but in terms of capabilities, it can compete with most modern multimeters. The only thing you definitely won't find in it is current measurement, but almost everything else is there. What was also surprising is that this device, despite its size, has a built-in power supply. The device is powered by just one 1.5-volt AAA battery. This power supply raises the voltage and in dial-up mode it can reach almost 4 volts. Let's check it out. So I turned it on in dialing mode. We measure. And the device showed us 3.9 volts. Connect the blue LED. As you can see, the voltage at its junction is more than 2.5 volts. Let me remind you that the battery in the device is only 1.5 volts. The same power supply allows for more complete use of battery energy. The manufacturer promises that the device will operate at a voltage of 0.8 volts. Let's check it out. Remove the battery from the multimeter. Instead, we connect a laboratory power supply from the GVDA company. We see a bright screen on the device. Let's see at what voltage it will go out. And at what voltage it will turn off altogether. Reducing tension. As you can see, at a voltage of 0.5 volts the indicator shines weaker. But if we set it to 0.4 volts, then it is almost invisible. We return. That is, at 0.6 volts the indicator works well. Let's try something on. Let's measure the battery voltage. As you can see, even at a voltage of 0.6 volts, the multimeter correctly measures the voltage. Due to this function, the device uses battery energy as much as possible. At one time, electricians carried testers that were the same or larger in size than this multimeter. And now, instead of an electrician's tester, you can wear a device that has an order of magnitude more capabilities. The device has a clamp for fastening. We attach the multimeter to a pocket, put the wire in the same pocket and go for repairs. The device is supplied in such a box. She's pretty strong. Let's open it. There is foam rubber inside. This box with foam protects the device well during transportation. If desired, this foam rubber can be removed, and a spacious box will remain. You can also add a wire with a crocodile clip, electrical tape, terminal blocks and a screwdriver for them, or something else. There are such instructions in Chinese and English. But the device is quite simple and I think after this video, you will easily learn how to use this device. Let's open it. We install the battery, paying attention to the polarity. Let's close. Battery is not included in delivery. The device immediately switched to auto mode. You can turn the device off and on by holding the red button for a long time. It's turned off. Turned it on. If you hold this button for a long time, you can turn on the flashlight, which is quite bright. Turn it off. Middle button. Turns on the hold mode. To hold the readings on the display after measurements. Hold turned on. Turn it off. What I also like about this device is that it has a fairly large and bright display. As big as they could make for such a small multimeter. True, the rest of the icons are small green. But they are very contrasting and clear, and therefore easy to read. The screen can be tilted and the numbers on it are not distorted. Please note that the range of readings on the display is from 0 to 5999. The readings are updated 3 times per second. Let's measure something with this multimeter. Remove the plugs from the wire. We also remove this protective cover on the multimeter probe. We connect the cord. By default, the automatic measurement mode is turned on and auto is shown on the display. This device allows you to automatically measure direct and alternating voltage, measure resistance and make continuity tests. First, the device tests the presence of voltage on the probes of more than 0.8 volts. If it detects it, it switches to voltage measurement mode. If it is not there, it switches to the dialing or resistance measurement mode. When the resistance on the probes is less than 50 ohms, a beep sounds. Due to automatic testing, the device gives readings with a delay. Let's switch to manual mode. At the same time, dialing works almost instantly. That is why I prefer manual dialing mode. Let's return to auto mode. Let's measure the battery voltage. 9.25 volts. And the device shows that the voltage is constant by displaying the DC icon. If the probes are swapped, then we will have a minus. AC voltage is also measured, only the AC icon is displayed. Let's measure the resistance. This resistance is 220 ohms. It is 220 ohm and shows. Here is a resistance of 1 ohm. It actually shows this value. Taking into account the error in the value of the resistor itself. The device selects the measurement range itself. Which range he chose is indicated by a sign. As you can see, to the right of the number it is displayed that the measurements are in kiloohms. Automatic selection of the measurement range is typical for all measurement modes in this device. According to the instructions, in automatic mode you can measure capacitance and check diodes. But I do not recommend doing this. In this mode the device does not do it correctly. Let's look at manual measurement modes. Press the red button. Let's move on to measuring DC voltage. For example, let's measure the voltage on the chrono. Please note that the device showed voltage faster than in automatic mode. Press the red button. We switch to the AC voltage measurement mode. We insert the probes into the socket. Press the hold button. Let's look at the result. 235 volts. Please note that the AC icon is now on, which means that we are in AC voltage measurement mode. Direct voltage can be measured up to 1000 volts, and alternating voltage up to 700 volts. The input impedance of the device is 10 mOhm. Exiting hold mode. Press the red button and go to the capacitance measurement mode. This capacitor is 330 nanofarads. We measure. Ours showed 321 nanofarads. We take an electrolytic capacitor. We measure. The device thought for a bit and showed 103 millifarads. The capacitor body indicates 100 millifarads. The capacitor is new, so its capacity is slightly larger. Press the button and go to diode testing mode. As you can see, there is a diode icon here. When connected directly to an LED, it shows the voltage drop across the junction. Now let's check the red LED. You can see the voltage drop across the LED. Now let's turn the LED over. When connected back, the device shows OL. In the same mode we can ring circuits. When the resistance is less than 50 ohms, a beep sounds. The device shows the resistance of a closed circuit. But in this mode, the device correctly measures only small resistances. For example, let's try to measure a resistance of 220 ohms. As you can see, the device has not switched from the diode test mode and is showing incorrect data. Press the button again. The device displays the temperature in degrees Celsius from the sensor inside the device. If you press the button again, the same temperature, only in Fahrenheit. Press again. The device switches to frequency measurement mode. I'm not going to get the generator. It's funny that the device can show the frequency of interference on the probes. If you hold one probe with your fingers. By pressing again, we return to auto mode. And then all modes will switch in a circle. The device has a non-contact detection of the presence of alternating voltage in the network. Press this button and go to EF mode. In this mode, the wire can be removed. We bring the device to the outlet. We display a scale from 1 to 4 lines. And the indicator light works. And the buzzer beeps. The closer we bring the device to the outlet, the more dashes we have. The red signal now lights up and the buzzer sounds more often. Here we have the maximum electric field. We press the button again, and we go to the phase detection mode. We take the socket. We insert it. If the wire is neutral, the device ignores it. And if we connect a phase, the red indicator lights up, and the buzzer often sounds. If we press the button again, we go to the phase sequence check mode. This is necessary for those electricians who deal with asynchronous three-phase motors. The direction of rotation of the motor depends on the phasing. I have never needed this function and I will not consider it. To exit these modes, just press the red button. In this case, we switch to automatic measurement mode. To prevent the battery from running out, the device has an auto shutoff function, which works 5 minutes after you stop using the device. This is such a simple and necessary device. I'm going to use it in my car. It has many functions and takes up little space. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. By tradition, I leave a link to the device in the description. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss new videos. Share the video with those who may be interested in this device. Special thanks to those who help the channel financially. Like and see you in new and old videos.